Paradise Report is recorded in front of a live stadium audience. As such, the use of industrial language is not uncommon. If you're listening in the company of wee innocent ears, turn off now and listen back later. Although, let's face it, half of them could teach us a thing or two about swearing. Hail hail and welcome to Paradise Report number 41 on Hail Hail Media. This week, the curtain came down on another season in the Scottish football as Celtic faced Hibernian in the Scottish Cup final. Would Celtic once more falter at Hampden and allow Hibernian to end their 111 year long wait to lift the trophy, or would the Bhoys cap a wonderful season in style by clinching the double? Hope you enjoy it. Good afternoon from Scotland's National Stadium, Hampden Park. It is the final day of the season. We are here for the Scottish Cup final between Celtic, the Greens of the West, and Hibernian, the Greens of the East. So Hampden Park will be green and white. Pretty nervous today. Really, really want to clinch this double. Really, really don't want to be the team that Hibernian end their 111 year wait for the third time to get their hands on this trophy. They beat us in 1902. That was the last time they won it. And of course they won in 1887, which was something that sparked our founding. So I'd rather not be involved in the third one as well. The fact that Willie Collum is today's referee and his extra officials makes me a bit nervous as well. However, Willie Collum is our match official, we tend to have to be at our best, because if we're not, he tends to make a difference. And of course, as Hampden, we've had some pretty poor performances before, but we've had some great performances as well. The last time the Scottish Cup final was here, 2011 against Motherwell. Chucking it down that day, but we did beat them 3-0. Charlie Mulgrave finalising it with a late free kick. I forget the images of the raindrops flying off the net, slow motion. But that was 2 years ago, all different today. Hibs will be well up for us. Hopefully we are too. And the team that will be taking the field for Celtic today consists of Fraser Forster in goal, a back four of Emilio Izaguirre. Charlie Mulgrew's made it, he's at the back, alongside Kelvin Wilson. Michael Lustig completes the back four in midfield. James Forrest has also made it. He's joined by Joe Ledley, Captain Scott Brown, and Chris Commons, and up front, the partnership we've seen so well the last few years, Gary Hooper and Anthony Stokes. On the bench, we have Lucas Zaluska, Tom Rogic, Georgios Samaras, F.A. Ambrose, and Paddy McCourt. Just the five subs today, obviously. Haven't heard the Hibs team yet. There was some doubt over Lee Griffiths. James McPake hasn't made it. He will not be playing today. Although, from what I've heard, his form has been pretty poor, so that might be a blow for us more than for them. It's been a longer run to the final than usual, of course. Starting back in November with the fourth round, trying to fit in a winter break. And we played Arbroath. And Hibs played Hearts, knocked them out. So, it was a wee bit of payback for losing the final last year. Obviously we went to replay, had to go all the way up there to Arbroath. 1-0 win thanks to Adam Matthews. But since then we've beaten the Raith Rovers up in Kirkcaldy. Hibs beat Aberdeen that round. Then we were away to St Mirren in the quarter final. A wee bit of payback for them knocking us out of the League Cup semi final and beating 2-1. As Kilmarnock were the team that Hibs beat down in Rugby Park. And of course there was the semi finals here. Both of them were 4-3 after extra time. Hibs coming from 3-0 down to beat Falkirk in extra time. And we had a topsy-turvy game between us and Dundee United, and Anthony Stokes getting the winner in extra time. So it's been a long way. Hopefully it's a successful end here. Kick off is about 50 minutes away now. Weather here is blue skies, a bit of cloud in the sky, it's patchy. It may rain later, according to the weather reports, it may not. It seems to have changed about 15 times since I checked it today. It was meant to rain this morning as far as I heard, and it was going to be 3 o'clock rain, and now it's 5 o'clock maybe. That is at the moment glorious sunshine and quite warm, so I've left the jacket in the car, as a Scottish Cup final should be. Alright, just seen the Hibs team. Griffiths has made up. That was a bit of psychology, I think. He's up front with Owen Doyle. At the back, they've got a young lad, Foster. Yes, the same as our keeper's name. He is in for James McPake, obviously. Kevin Thompson, formerly of Rangers and formerly of Hibs, back at Hibs again, playing for nothing, I heard. He's in the team as well today. So it's a strong team for both. Hopefully it'll be a good, if one-sided in Celtic's favour, way. Alright, we've now reached the point in the afternoon where each team gets a tune. As you can hear, Hibs have started with international sunshine and Leith. It's certainly sunshine in Glasgow at the moment. Hopefully this is the only time we'll be hearing this today. Because as much as it's a nice tune, not a day. I hate to say it, but watching the Hibs fans at the opposite end of the stadium singing along to that, it's actually quite impressive. Must be like what happens when you watch us sing another walk alone, which conveniently is about what we're doing. And while we stood and watched, Hibs are now booing. Fun before the game. Two good sing songs. Everybody's up for us today. And we've got 18 minutes to kick off them. Alright, we've got men bringing the trophy out now. Pierre Van Hooydonk, Jorge Cadetti, but it sounds yet. No, Pierre Van Hooydonk, Russell Happy, obviously. I know Jorge's in the city. Pierre is the man on the trophy, Russell Atapé. Well, I think he played in 2001. But Pierre has lifted that thanks to his goal in 1995 against Airdrie. Oh, Russell Atapé's lifted it up. Oh, well, I suppose you take the advantage of what you can, eh? And now big Pierre there. Oh, that was a long 6 years. statement announcer confused me. I thought he said there was a couple for each team. One for each team. Oh, I got an interview. Almost there now. The balloons with the two badges are now being lifted aloft. Both ends have got a tifo ready to be displayed when the two teams come out. It's got to be far away now. Stripes out on the pitch as well. Green and white hoops at our end and a big block of green at their end with white run up. The two balloon badges towards the dugouts and then rotated around the two stands facing the ends at the moment. Wind seems to be causing a bit of problem for a Celtic one. Trying their best to hang on here. Maybe a nice sunny day, but there is a bit of wind. Ball boys now coming out of the tunnel. Got the balloons under control, they'll take another position again. I usually slate the build up for these games. Hampden's terrible at it, but it's actually not been too bad. So we keep it up with competition at one point as well. Have to show off your skills. The expert does that, the fans done that, won that one. I'm sure we'll get the usual half time, 10 second challenge. It's just a tradition at Hampden Park. It's been good, I'm just itching to get going. The nerves are jangling, I just want to get into the action. Oh, we're getting pyros in the pitch now. Flames of fire. It's alright, we need it, eh? Feel the heat coming off him. Stadium pretty much full now. Struggling to find any spaces at all. That is a 50-50 split. Alright, the teams are in the tunnels. Subs are ready. And here come the two teams now. The tifos go up. Big Scottish Cup back at the Hibs end. A big 1888 at Celtic end. And the Celtic badge with Brother Wilfred on it emerging from the bottom. Today short of our first ever game, 125th anniversary of that was the 28th of May 1888, and now the 26th of May 2013. Here we are again. Essentially, we could we won the double that year, 1630 season. Can we do it again, the 125th year? Now being cleared off all the fabric, you know, the all nonsense you don't need for a football game. Goalkeepers, their captain today, he's doing the handshakes and coin toss with Scott Brown. Changing up banners. And it's the last of the fabric gets cleared off the pitch. Scott Brown running over to carry out the huddle. So for the final time this season, here we go. The Scottish Cup final, it will be Celtic to kick off. Let's get cracking. I reckon Lee Griffiths has been off twice already, and the linesman has been pitch flag up either time. Second time the linesman's got a corner out there, so first real chance for Hibs now. The ball up down, Mulgrew heads clear. Hibs put it back in, man at the edge of the box has a shot, just over the bar. Well, last year Hibs were terrible when it started, but they're well up for this one. Not making the same mistake twice. Hibs definitely more up for us than us at the moment. Cracking ball in for their left hand side, their right. Heather was heading for the top corner, but Fraser Foster managed to claw it away. Celtic need to get going, need to settle last game. Hibs closing in well. They seem to be playing speculative long balls up the field. We're having a real one in here.
Griffith still
gets
the ball.
1-0 Celtic, Gary Hooper, his first goal of the tournament! 8 minutes gone! Campbell off it right to Rustig, he's fired across field. Nobody there to get it, but Hibs didn't clear it properly. Andy Stokes picked it up before it went out. Fired at a cracking ball at the back post, and Hooper guided it on with his foot. That's the answer to Hibs' early pressure. A first decent chance of balls in the net. Maybe this Celtic was held in. nearly 2-0 there. Joe Eddie got played down. The keeper managed to pounce on it just in time. Celtic starting to show a bit of dominance now. Passing looks a bit more secure. Less pressure. So I'd like to see where the goal has settled him a bit. Looks like he's getting a lot of space down on the right hand side at the moment. Just got another good ball through to him. Had a decent ball in, but the keeper came out and collected up. Not sure Stokes was going to get on it anyway. The defender seemed to have just have enough on him. Bit of panic here as he thought the ball was going to leave Griffiths, but it was always going through to Foster. Maybe just their angle. Well, Hooper had released Stokes there on the left hand side. Tried to cut in, have a shot, want to hit the side net, mate, though. So, 20 minutes gone in our Scottish Cup final. Hibs certainly still hassling away. But, really troubled Foster since that header early before it was an open goal. Still a long way to go in this final, though. Lee Griffiths is struggling quite badly. Still in the park, still trying his best, but he's stretching at every opportunity and he just doesn't look right. I wonder how long Hibs will persist with him, because he's still causing us problems despite his injury worries. Celtic getting behind again there. Joel Edley never quite caught and ended it properly. Hibs are able to scramble it clear. Mainly because we had nobody else on the other side of the box. Forrest was behind his man, he was the only one around. As Kevin Wilson fires a long pass out of the park. We do seem to be going for long ball quite a lot today. And to be fair, it's working every so often. Especially when we can get him behind. Some of them are too close to the keeper, but there's definitely a plan now.
Gary Hooper makes it 2-0 with Celtic! Another good ball for Stokes here, another time in a back post. Header this time. Just past the half hour mark, 2-0 Celtic. And Gary Hooper could become the first man since Dixie Deans to get a hat trick in the Scottish Cup final for Celtic. It's on. I think the last Scottish Cup hat trick was Gordon Jury in the 90s when Rangers beat Hearts. But the Stokes and Hooper partnership's paying dividends today. Oh, meanwhile Stokes is in behind again. No, the defender's managed to get a foot in and get it clear. Well, as far as Mulgrew, Lee Griffiths is down injured again. So they're trying to come forward. It's a foul eventually for Ledley. Trying to get the ball for Hibs defender. Griffiths back on his feet again, no. I say he's back on his feet, he's back down again getting treatment now. It'll be interesting to see what the physio says here. I'd kind of like Griffiths to persist. Well, I'm having a fit striker in the park. I've got Ross Calder on the bench. Young lad, that's pretty good. Griffiths on his feet. Obviously needs to go off because he's got treatment. So Griffiths back on the park again. Still doesn't look happy. But he is persisting. 10 minutes to half time now. Well, Chris Collins on effort for Fallen Angel just by the post. It was a long ball up the field, and Stokes didn't quite make it this time, but the defender dropped it for Collins. He picked it up, thought he'd have a lash at it. Oh, Mulgrew got away with one there. He tried to let the ball go through to Foster. Totally unaware that Lee Griffiths was behind them. Lee Griffiths went in, got round the keeper, but the angle was too tight, and all he could do was play it across the face of goal. But that was a great moment for Hibs to get back into this game, because Mulgrew was no awareness whatsoever of who was around them. Last time he went to an error to let him back in. It's currently the game is under control. But that kind of thing can get the team up for it and spark a comeback. I'm right in front of the TV studio. We've just spotted who's behind us. And a few waves from him as well. A couple more mistakes creeping in for Celtic now. Hibs have a corner now. I'm getting the passing right. No chance for Hibs to get back into this. Griffiths is going to take it. Swapped in, it's a good ball, punched, clear, and it's going to fall. Hibs man at the edge of the box, so he does is fire it up. Closer to the corner flag than the goal. I think he was getting closed down. I don't think he could do too much with it except find out the way he was facing. Very unlucky for Celtic there. Stokes plucked one out of the air brilliantly and tried to play it through to Hooper. The defender just caught there to block it. Bunch of half time now. Minute to go. It's back at the Hibs keeper at the moment. Launches it forward. Mulgrew wins a header, drops to Brown. To Kevin Wilson. So I think looking pretty settled at the moment. You do think if Hibs get back into this, it's going to be a silly mistake. You never know. When that across field pass, it looks like it's going to run out for a throw in. Kevin Wilson just gets it on time. He's got two men closing them down. Plays it to Foster. He's getting shut down now. He launches it forward. Finds Stokes. Flicks it on to where Hooper's running. Can get a decent ball in. Switches it across to where Forrest is. Forrest needs to strike this, he hasn't. He's tried to play it to Commons, and all he's done is run out for a goal kick because Commons is on the wrong way. If he strikes that, it's a great chance. There's space to do it, he just bottled it. A minute added on. Rooney puts in another challenge in midfield. He's run that midfield so far. Wanyama and Kyle have got bookings to keep them out of this. Well, I worried about who the midfield was going to be, but fortunately bringing it back in time. What a difference he's made. Yeah. Stokes trying to play a cheeky wee dink, run down the touchline. His wee dink took it over the touchline. Hibs throw on. Mr. Griffiths is back to the minute throw up. He launches it down the line. Bounces in. As the guy has to take a touch on it. He's in his own corner at the moment. Man's kicked him twice. Plays it to Mulgrew. And there's a half time whistle. Celtic lead 2-0 at the break. And in control. He's got to take another half time team talk from Pat Fenlon, just like he did against Falkirk when they were 3-0 down at this point. So we know Hibs are capable of it. There's hope Celtic are better than Falkirk at seeing these things out. Alright, Celtic first out of the tunnel for the start of the second half. We watched the subs warm up. I don't think we're getting any substitutions at first half. Start of the second half. Hibs out now. All but officials. Thank you. ready to go again. 45 minutes to go. We have to kick off a second half. Hopefully more of the same for Celtic. I'd imagine Hibs will be pushing for at least a goal early. There you go again. Frantic start to this half. The number 33 for Hibs is causing us all sorts of problems down the Ulster side. And then another point, Mulgrew long ball, hit through to Chris Commons, and just managed to catch it before a minute for a goal kick. He flipped it across, but it was behind Hooper. And Hibs are able to get it clear. Certainly no way up the pace of this game. Celtic on behind again, nope. One ball to Commons, played it to Hooper, he was in a good position. He cut it across to James Forrest, he had to try and take a couple of touches to get in the man. Just couldn't nick it away to get a shot away. Good for a goal kick. Celtic turned it up just a wee gear there. This time it was Stokes out wide. Cut in, took a shot, and it swerved away for the goal instead of the words up. Oh, good move by Celtic though. Hibs players about to go in the book. Half challenge of Scott Brown. And the first booking of the game is a bit of afters as well. Arguing with Brunny. Watch Brunny get a book on honour. We'll book the challenge and book Brown as well. But then you were going to book the challenge anyway, so surely you should be booking again for the argument afterwards if you book Brown. I bet he does. Yep, Brown, yep, booking to each. As per usual, the challenge itself was bookable. So the fight afterwards is another booking, separate incident. So really, for Hibs man arguing with Scott Brown, Brown is the only one to get booked for that. Because the challenge is being the book anyway. Poor referee. A wee bit of pressure for Hibs now. It's getting their fans going. Just turning it up again. And we're not really controlling the ball at the moment. But we have been. Hoofing it straight back to them at times. Oh, they've just made a mess of the throw. No, Celtic are getting possession back now. Celtic just need to settle a wee bit now. Celtic fans have gone kind of quiet, huh? Giving a ball away again. Charlie Mulgrew get taken out though. That by Lee Griffiths. And he was clearing up. What's the ref doing now? Yellow card for Lee Griffiths. Late challenge, Wiccan. I know the Hibs fans are doing a power of moaning at the moment, but everything the ref's given has been spot on. Oh, good ball down the right hand side this time. James Forrest got on it. Long over the top again. Tried to play it into the centre. Never really for a Celtic player, unfortunately. But did break to Hooper. But he was always stretching to try and get it. Looking over the keeper, sent it over the bar as well. Alright, in the 71st minute, Hibs are the first minute of substitution. Oh, Doyle coming off. I guess it's Ross Colwell going on then. No, it's another guy I don't know.
That's him three up front.
I'm not sure about that. Guy in front of me says a three up front. I'm sure Owen Doyle was up front. Danny Handlin, that's what it's. So they'll be changing it. Fresh legs up front. Trying to cause us some more problems. Alright, Celtic men, their first sub. Chris Commons coming off. George Samaras coming on. We're under a cosh a bit at the moment. Hibs men, our sub as well. There's Ross Caldwell coming on now. Hibs need to go for it. And they are. That was a Hibs corner. And Griffiths launches it in. It comes out the other side. Scott Brim picks it up there. Nudges it off a Hibs player. Out for a Celtic throw.
3-0 Celtic to Hibs!
Listed far that cross, Hooper really should have buried it himself. He fell over, but he managed to fall to Joe Ledley, and he fired that in the top corner. And with 12 minutes to go, the Hibs fans are heading for the exit because they know this Celtic are going to be left in the cup just shortly. Effie Ambrose is strapped and ready, come on. Three in all way. 1 minute to go, that'll be some comeback if Hibs can manage it now. 10 minutes to go, sorry. Malcolm's just giving handball for nothing. Anyway, Effie Ambrose is ready to come on, and he will be coming on for Scott Brown. Handball passes to Ledley. 80 minutes out of Bruni. He has run that midfield today. So glad he made it back for us. Don't know how we'd have done with him. Not sure where Effie Ambrose is going to go. Centre back, I think. Free kick by Hibs, launched forward and cleared. Samaras has it now, he's going to carry it forward. Plays it forward to Stokes. Stokes switches it to Hooper, nearly the defender gets there. I think Hooper's going to be struggling to get his hat track. I think the chance was there at the third goal. I don't think I mind too much.
John Boyce going up.
I'm ready with our last substitution. Not too keen to make it yet, I don't think. Except that I've got a throw in. Nice football by Celtic at the moment. Ledley on the ball, heading towards goal. Tries to play a Hooper, takes a deflection of Hibs man, and he gets forward. We've got it back here, no Stokes now. In the centre circle. Is it right to Mulgrew? Forrest now. Samaras has made a run, he's a bit annoyed in Magora. Forrest running forward here. Shooting for a shot, plays it to Samaras. Samaras tries to give him it back. And Hibs get it clear again. That is all Celtic at the moment. Stokes now. 1-2 with Forrest. Plays it Forrest again. Forrest turns, plays it across to Ledley. Ledley plays it out wide to Izaguirre, who's in behind again. Takes a couple of touches to control, and the Hibs defender manages to get in there. Hit it off him, get the throw. And Hibs will now make that substitution. Clay Griffiths is going off. 83 minutes for a guy that's holding back up. Was a doubt before. Done now. He's really struggled with it. Hasn't had much service either. Had that one chance in the first half when Mulgrew was sleeping. It was always a tight angle when he went round. Did his best to get up, but wasn't to be. And Lewis Stevenson will come on for the final few minutes of the game. I'm hearing him sing, but they do have a corner. Mulgrew's just giving him up. To be fair, there was a man right up behind them, probably faster than them. Corner comes in, it's a decent one, and it's headed clear by Mulgrew. A bit of treatment for a Habs man. And they call him for a physio, he's down. He's back up. Anyway, no physio then. He's fine. 5 minutes to go. Cheers going up there as we got a little glimpse of the cup being carved. I'd imagine the name of Celtic going on up. Paddy McCourt coming on for the last few minutes of the game. He is stripped and ready. The free kicks that they had have taken up. Oh, and Effie Ambrose is giving it away though. It's played out wide. The 29 takes a shot, a few deflections, and Kelvin Wilson manages to just clear it away. Not quite away yet though. Stop for the 16. Hibs goes out wide to the 8. On the left hand side now, 3 minutes to go. Back inside 20. Hibs knocked that a bit. Long hopeful ball behind the goal, and it's out for a goal kick. James Forrest, the man coming off to let Paddy McCourt go on. To be fair, the Hibs fans still singing loudly. We're giving a good account of himself today, but it just wasn't to be today. Celtic have been too good. 2 minutes to go. Paddy McCourt is captain. Joe Edley's giving them the armband. You'd imagine this is his final act as a Celtic player. What an honour. Turn the ball now, put it forward to Hooper. He plays it out wide to Anthony Stokes. Stokes takes a touch, tries to play it in. It hits the first defender. It's broken back to Stokes though. Sort of cut in, takes a few touches, plays it back to McCourt. McCourt hits the byline, has to check back because he can't get the cross in, plays it back to Stokes. Stokes angling for a shot, whips it in, just over the bar. Stokes against man of the match. Had my big game at Scott Brown, to be honest, but Stokes has had a decent game as well. Not on the score sheet today, but two terrific balls in for the Gary Hooper goals. The board goes up, 2 minutes to be added on. I'm avented it now. Hibs coming forward looking for a consolation. Kelvin Wilson trying to see it out. He can't as he gets tackled. Still got it. Plays it forward. It was only as far as Willie Collum. Hibs have it on the edge of the box. Shot one fired. Wide in a post. Also, Dixie Deans is going to remain the last Celtic player to score the hat trick in a Scottish Cup final. It would have been funny if Hooper had done it today, of course, because Dixie's hat trick came against Hibs. I believe we're applauding, the Hibs fans are still singing. Stokes has it wide, launches it. towards. Ramirez doesn't make it. Ambrose picks it up on the flicks it on the house player. Hibs bringing it forward slowly. Number 29's on it, right. Was it forward, Hibs in the box. Good little move this, looking to turn and shoot. And it's lashed away by Celtic. Out for a throw. And Hibs even going to get a consolation. The whistle looks to be in the mouth now. Maybe. Not Paddy McCourt's cut out. He's carrying it forward. That's it off a Hibs player. Out for a throw. Mister takes a throw, where is he getting a throw? That's a full time whistle! Celtic won the Scottish Cup and the double! So Hibs' long wait goes on. Andy Lennon joins Jock Steen and Billy McNeil as men who have won the double for Celtic as both player and manager. And now a long wait for the board to be built up. Hibs fans still singing. It's not a 5-1 hiding they got last year. Better account of themselves last year, but better team won in the day. They might look back to that Lee Griffiths chance and wonder what could have been. Shakes all around at the moment. And despite the fact I've been playing in black all day, the hoops are now coming out. So if you're going to raise your cup, you need to do it at your home kit. The famous green and white hoops. To be fair, with the hoops on in the black shorts, they look a bit like Sporting Lisbon, but hey-ho. It was all very friendly today. We just applauded Hibs. They were away applauding their own fans. We got to the halfway line. I think Lee Griffiths was just certainly directing applause our way. Maybe he's angling for a transfer. Who knows? He's coming over to where the Celtic players are. Scott Brown was getting interviewed by Chick Young on the BBC. Neil Lennon's about to get interviewed by the looks here on the telly. Right, here we go. Cup is ready to be presented. Campbell Ogilvie getting the right treatment. Shocking, he's starting a job here. Hibs got up there, the runners up medals. Applause from
all sections of the stadium. Never good to go up and get your nose up, medal. I don't know how much you want to talk about, but somebody's got to lose a day. Alright, that's the last of the Hibs players. We've got their medals. Now sending the referees and all officials up to get theirs. No great bearing in the game today, but that's probably for the best. Nothing worse than when a final is made all about the referee and the teams that took part. That hasn't happened today, so that's good. I don't think the officials behind the goal have much to do, to be honest. So I don't know whether that experiment's worked or not. Obviously, we've seen it in Europe before. Never really been impressed by it. Cup is now placed on the stand. The green and white ribbons are on it. Could have put that one earlier, to be honest. I hope Campbell, although his face is like fizz when he needs to hand us over to Celtic. As Scott Brown leads him up. They're climbing the stairs, Foster behind them. And McCourt, Stokes, Commons, Izaguirre, Hooper, Ledley, Lustig. Brennan's reached out, lads, grabs the cup, there's hands, and we're still on! Passes it to Foster. Passes it to McCourt. Passes it to Stokes. I don't believe the Titans are on the tannoy. Hooper. Ledley. Westing. Camera keeps cutting away. Camera Wilson there. Pass it to James Forrest. I'll be with the cup now, passes it to Neil Lennon. And that's Lennon's privilege to carry it down the steps, and I want to take that place on the podium for the foes. And I'm all getting Glasgow's green and white t-shirts. Well, Edinburgh's green and white have pretty much vacated the stadium now. They'll break our hoodie eventually. Ideally, not against us. He's currently has a cup. Everybody up the stand now, apart from Stokes, who's getting interviewed. As he always manages to find the Honduras flag for something. And a ticker tape flyer now.
right time to parade the cup. Well, Gary Hoover's just under his head there. Getting plenty of photos. Those are his two goals today. They were the big difference. Went like capped off at the end. In the parade. But I'm Kyle in the party at the moment. Couldn't play today, suspended. He's in the cup, passes it to Samaras. What a man, Daniel Suits, Wayama as well. Thomas Rogner. Tom McGeek's here as well. Not quite as far along the parade this year. 2 years ago we were almost all the way down the north stand. And today we're just short of the halfway line. Which oddly is the half of the stand. I don't exactly understand how that works. It's just in my perspective, to be honest. So we're in a board in the crowd now, chanting his name. Joe Ledley down there, showing off his Welsh flag, holding the cup. Neil Lennon now passing us. Rachel, we're not all these. Effie Ambrose now getting pictures of the cup. There's a Foster on Novar giving away his. Well, I think it's his t-shirt he's going to wear. Still got his tap on. Big team 40 in front of the north stand now. Take as many of them out as possible. Lenny's got a cough at the moment now. Second time he's won this, a manager of course. Never won it about 4 times so far. 2001, 2004, 2005, even 2007. 2011 and 2013, that's a manager, that's somehow. And they're now playing his song in the tannoy. If you listen to this every week. I wish I could have heard that one, didn't I? Brennan's trying to get some away now. He's going to be his t-shirt. Oh, it's his boots. And he's at the top half now, and that gets farther in the crowd and all. I can't notice the shots after. Melissa Commons, she's got the cup now. Sorry ladies, also Scott Brown's the only one doing the staff off. In fact, Sammy's just given him his Glasgow's Grey White t-shirt. He stuck that on to get picture up with Chris Collins with a cup. Sammy's got a Greek flag. Collins goes off to let Brown get pictures with a cup himself. Triumphant captain. More or less the last man up the park, Neil Lennon over at the north stand still. The cops and safe fans. Chris Commons running over to hand over his boots to the crowd now. Ah, he's shooting them out. One to one person, one to another. Double winners, 13 in the back of the jersey. Going to show it after another bunch of photographers. Anthony Stokes being interviewed by Chick Young, just finishing up there. Hooper's running off now. He was trying to run off, he's just been grabbed by Chick Young. Well, he's finished his interview. And Bruni's dropped the lid. Oh no, he's not dropped the lid, he dropped something else. He did have it in his head, holding up the ribbons. Very brave for an old trophy like that. And his tab's off again. That's getting farther to the crowd, I know. Last off the field, waving at the crowd. What's he doing? Hugging people. It's just mingling with the fans, just as you do. If somebody had a big hug. And finally he heads in the tunnel. And so ends season 2012-2013. Celtic's 125th anniversary celebrated with a double. And on that happy note, it is time to go home or go to the pub or otherwise go and celebrate. I look forward to a nice summer, which isn't too long because we've got Champions League qualifying in July. But that's for future. For now, party time. Hail, hail.
So there you are, that's us for another podcast. And indeed, that's us for another season. I don't know about you, but I've absolutely loved it. The European campaign was obviously the major highlight, but any year you finish as champions and get to add the cup to the trophy cabinet is a brilliant season in my book. The season might be over and we can relax and enjoy the summer, but it won't be too long before we're back in action again. With the Champions League qualifying coming up as early as mid-July, the players will be back in training before we know it and we'll be ready to go again. Wouldn't it be great if next season could live up to this one, or would that just be greedy? Either way, it's going to be fun finding out. But for now, I'll leave with some memories of this one. This has been the Paradise Report. Talk to you all again soon.
us time for a nice wee break and just to soak up the fact that we are 3-0 up and quite possibly the last of our game against Rangers. Take that in. Imagine how good life will be next year without all this nonsense. Feels good, doesn't it?
So the company that is Rangers Football Club will fall. The football continues, but there is a break in tradition. It will be a new Rangers.
Dundee will replace Rangers in the Clydesdale Bank Premier League next season. The Iron Brew First Division runners-up were chosen ahead of relegated Dunfermline, joining the SPL's annual general meeting at Hampden today. Despite reports of a possible U-turn in recent days, SPL clubs agreed to work with the decision by the Scottish Football League to put Newco Rangers in the third division.
Good evening from Celtic Park. It's 5-7 and we're here for our first competitive match of the season. The Celtic will face Helsinki in the first leg of the third qualifying round as we try and make the Champions League group stages for the first time in several seasons. John Bull's a club, and a high flag is unfurled! And it is a full-time whistle! Celtic go on the Champions League group stages draw on Friday! Helsingborg, well, they're off to the Europa League.
Ball going up to the back post.
Season, it is Celtic 1, Barcelona 0! What's in behind us? 2-0! 2-0 Celtic! Tony fucking Wall! Tony Wall! Tony Wall! Tony Wall! Tony Wall! Celtic have beaten Barcelona, the reigning world champions, by 2-1 here at Celtic Park. It's a glorious victory, another 3 points in the Champions League, that takes us on in 7, and puts us in a terrific position now.
Good evening from Estadio de Luz in Lisbon.
Ball group fires at the back post. It's in! 1-1!
They've just summoned us when it was a game! Well, that's a first! A goal for Celtic and Lisbon against Benfica!
Whistle goes.
And off the ball! Oh, that was inch perfect! Watered it in the middle and off the crossbar! We're playing London Calling, are we through though? Full time boss one and open thinking now! We're in the last 16!
Runs up.
Foster saves! Absolutely solid save, in for a corner.
He touches it to Commons, he touches it to Mulgrew, he fires in a shot and it's in the net. 3-2. Too late though, that's a full time whistle. That is the very last action of the game. We'll go to Turin. Fans are heading over there, they're having an enjoyable time, but realistically this guy's done already. Commons works out in the back post, free header up the air, overhead kick.
And in the fucking net! 4-3 at Celtic! Oh, that was on right here, it was Salmon as an overhead kick! He's taking his glove off, he's swinging all about, he'll get booked for that. I don't think anybody in here cares.
Glasgow Celtic champions once again. Mister takes a throw, there is a gate, there is a full time whistle! Celtic won the Scottish Cup and a double!